नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। We are reading from Bhagavad Gita as it is, chapter number 14 and text number 26. Mam cha yaha avyabhicharena bhakti yogena saha sevate saha गुणान समतित्य एतान ब्रह्मभूयाय कल्पते मां च यो अव्यभिचारेण भक्तियोगेन सेवते स गुणान समत्येतान ब्रह्म भूयाय कल्पते मां च यो अव्यभिचारेण भक्ति योगेन सेवते स गुणान समतीतेतान ब्रह्म भूयाय कल्पते मां च यो अव्यभिचारेण भक्तियोगेन सेवते स गुणान समत्येतान ब्रह्म भूयाय कल्पते Mam unto me, cha also, yaha a person who, avyabhicharena, without fail, bhakti yogena, by devotional service, sevate, tender service, Saha. He. Gunan. The modes of material nature. Samatitya. Transcending. Etan. All these. Brahma Bhuyaya. Elevated to Brahman platform. Kalpate. Becomes. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. One who engages in full devotional service, unfailing in all circumstances, at once transcends the modes of material nature and thus comes to the level of Brahman. This verse is a reply to Arjuna's third question. What is the means of attaining to the transcendental position? As explained before, the material world is acting under the spell of the modes of material nature. One should not be disturbed by the activities of the modes of nature. Instead of putting his consciousness into such activities, he may transfer his consciousness to Krishna activities. Krishna activities are known as bhakti yoga, always acting for Krishna. This includes not only Krishna, but his different plenary expansions such as Rama and Narayana. He has innumerable expansions. One who is engaged in service of any of the forms of Krishna or of his plenary expansion is considered to be transcendentally situated. One should also note that all the forms of Krishna are fully transcendental, blissful, full of knowledge and eternal. Such personalities of Godhead are omnipotent and omniscient, and they possess all transcendental qualities. So, if one engages himself in the service of Krishna or his plenary expansion with unfailing determination, although these modes of material nature are very difficult to overcome, one can overcome them easily. This has already been explained in the 7th chapter. One who surrenders unto Krishna at once surmounts the influence of the modes of material nature. To be in Krishna consciousness or in devotional service means to acquire equality with Krishna. The Lord says that His nature is eternal, blissful and full of knowledge, and the living entities are part and parcel of the Supreme, as gold particles are the part of gold mine. Thus, the living entity in his spiritual position is as good as gold, as good as Krishna in quality. The difference of individuality continues. Otherwise, there should be no question of bhakti yoga. Bhakti yogena means that the Lord is there, the devotee is there, and the activity of exchange of love between the Lord and the devotee is there. Therefore, the individuality of two persons is present in the Supreme Personality of Godhead and the individual person, otherwise there would be no meaning of bhakti yoga. If one is not situated in the same transcendental position as the Lord, one cannot serve the Supreme Lord. To be a personal assistant to a king, one must acquire the qualifications. Thus, the qualifications is to become Brahman or freed from all material contamination. It is said in the Vedic literature, Brahmapi eti. One can attain the Supreme Brahman by becoming Brahman. This means that one must qualitatively become one with Brahman. By attainment of the Brahman, one does not lose his eternal Brahman identity as an individual soul. ॐ अज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुर्मिलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपकदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकं वन्देहं श्रीगुरो श्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरुन् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सहगणा रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादान् सहगणा ललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितांश्च हे कृष्ण करुणा सिन्धो दीनबन्धो जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिकाकान्त राधाकान्त नमस्तुते तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि श्रीहरिप्रिये वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिन्धुभ्यः एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः नमः ॐ विष्णुपादाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिन्निति नामिने नमस्ते सारस्वतीदेवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषशून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे जय श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौरभक्तवृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे मां च यो अव्यभिचारेण भक्तियोगेन सेवते सगुणान् समत्य इत्येतान् ब्रह्म भूयाय कल्पते Arjun is asking several questions about the nature of transcendence. What are the symptoms and how can one achieve the transcendence? For the foremost process is purification. Purification is required to attain transcendence. Now, purifying from so many different sources that contaminate us, external purification, internal purification, so many things are required. But all that process that apply as a material process itself is affected by the three modes of material nature, therefore purification is not complete. In Satya Yoga, for purification, there was meditation. Then in Treta Yoga, it was fire sacrifice. In Dwapar Yoga, it was charity. And in Kali Yoga, is holy name. But it is said that in the first three yugas, because the lifespan was multifold, that process of purification was also extensive. It was not easy. Process of purification requires time. And time is the factor that puts or keeps us into the effect of the modes of material nature. Time does not allow us to come out because it's a controlling factor. Automatically we do not become purified. So if we simply depend upon time, time is not. So that process was not being recommended, even though it was mandatory. In Kali Yuga it is not recommended at all. After proper purification on those in those yugas, then when properly purified, properly situated, he takes the holy name or surrenders to the Supreme Lord. Even the process of jnana is said to be purifying. Nahi jnanena sadrasam pavitram idam yad vidyate. But the jnana of Vedic jnana or the conclusive jnana about the Vedas to come to the knowing Krishna, that will be purifying. But Vedic knowledge does not properly purify as such. Right? And after all, in all those different levels, here Krishna is telling that one can immediately transcend if he takes pure devotional service. Devotional service is also falling into three categories. Sakam, Nishkam, and Mokshakam. And this process is, Sakam means one with one's all desires, whether they are material or doesn't matter, but desires are there. And they may not be aligned with Krishna's desire, but Krishna is able to fulfill that, but along with, you know, the process of freeing from the modes. So that is in between. For example, going to Vaikuntha. That's a purification required, but the purification comes along with our desires, which are still separate. Right? So, we may choose to come back, just like Jay and Vijay, if we are given opportunity. Other, we are stuck. Right? It's a liberated situation, but stuck. Not much exchange or exchange in awe and reverence in Vaikuntha. So that is again here it is the word avyabhicharena. If you have your own desires different from Krishna, then it's called vyabhichari bhakti. But avyabhicharan, it means one has to come on the turf of Lord Krishna's desire. That is avyabhicharan. And bhakti, sakam bhakti is vyabhichari bhakti. Akam bhakti means simply to please Krishna is avyabhichari bhakti. Mokshkam bhakti is also avoiding Krishna, therefore somehow or another it is not considered to be pure devotional service. So one has to come to immediately transcend, means accept anukulyena Krishna anushilanam, that is the acceptance. Pratikulam varjet, then all others, he will protect me. I don't have to do anything separately for me. I'm soul surrender, so he will maintain me. I will have to remain meek and humble because I'm a nobody. It means I must have smashed my false ego to accept very meager servant of the servant of the maintainer of gopis. Right? And I'm ready. I'm available. So the sixth character of Sharanagati is avyabhichari bhakti. So it is possible to transcend if we apply. Prabhupada brought avyabhichari bhakti. Did not compromise with anything. No sakam bhakti, no separate transactions or something in remuneration, and that comes from Prahlad Maharaj's instructions. He's telling to Lord Narsingadeva, my dear Lord Narsinga, you want to benedict me, but I'm a soul surrender. I don't need anything for me. But I'm your master. I want to give you. You should be obedient. Take it. I'm so pleased that I want to award you. Ask for yourself. Narasimha Bhagavan was not pleased because he was not asking. Then when he asked for liberation of his father. He was not pleased either. No. Your father was my eternal servant. I have already liberated him. Anybody who dies at my hand is liberated automatically. I want you to get the benediction. But avyabhichari bhakti said, my dear Lord, if you really want to give me, then my desire is that let me stay with these demons and preach them your glory so they can become devotee and I'll send them back to you. Anya bilashita shunyam jnana karmadanavrutam anukullena kashtanu shilanam bhakti ruttam. It is unparalleled avyabhichari bhakti. There is no contamination in bhakti. Otherwise, there are so many creeping agents in this Kali Yuga, including time, including. So, yes, for example, Srila Prabhupada says, if you want to become a pure devotee, it will take 1 second. Otherwise, it will take yugas. So, have we projected how much time do we need? Oh, I will not do. At the age of 70, when I will be disabled, I will think of surrendering to Krishna. Like that. So, up to that level, how can we say that, I'm also a pure devotee? No. One must be ready to surrender without any reservation. So, Srila Prabhupada says that this is transcending the three modes of material nature. Because it is totally devoting to Lord Krishna and on his turf that here, my dear Lord, if you think so, engage me. Prabhupada wrote on Jaladutta, my dear Lord, I do not know why have you brought me here. I'm following the order of my Guru Maharaj and I'm trying to go and preach, but whether they will understand my language or not. I have no qualification. They gave me the name Bhakti and Vedanta. Neither I have Bhakti nor I am a knowledger of Vedanta. But still I have full faith on your holy name. That is the only qualification. Haridas Thakur says, simply faith on only holy name will take us back home, back to God. Now, what does that mean? Faith. Therefore, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami took time to explain Shraddha, Shabde, Sudrada Vishwasa Karanishchaya, Krishna Bhakti Karile, Sarva Karma Krita. This is whether it is karma, akarma, or vikarma, doesn't matter. Krishna Bhakti. So, this is extraordinary shortcut. But one has to be very well acquainted with what is meant by avyabhichari bhakti. One has to be acquainted. And one must muster around. No complaints. Train ourselves in order to rise above the platform. Because otherwise, the world is fully restricted by the time appointments. Then, what they call job descriptions, whether one likes or not. These are all affected by the time, and ultimately you have to relinquish. So you can't be attached to your position and service even. You should be free. If somebody is moved from one department to another, there is a big havoc. People are stuck and they are attached. Now, attached means there are three modes of material nature going to be affected. But they can't equate that, oh, I'm also doing Krishna's service. But if you are doing Krishna's service, then here is an opportunity to become free from attachment. Srila Prabhupada also told, know everything. Know everything. So when there is requirement, you know, if you are given opportunity, you can utilize that. But you do not need to waste time. Wastage of time is a big factor. Always keep yourself engaged in service of Krishna favorably, not unfavorably. There comes the great part of devotees' interactions. In our interactions also we should develop avyabhichari bhakti, because that's a training ground. Otherwise, suppose if somebody has a thought that, oh, yes, bhakti yoga is one of the process, they say, for advancement or perfections. Manushyanam sahasreshu kaschid datate siddhaye yatatam api siddhanam kaschin mam veti tatvata. And bahunam janmanam ante jnanavam mam prapadyate vasudevam sarvamiti sa mahatma sudhu. So, right from a common man's platform, to become a Mahatma is not a merely an aspiration or merely a chance. But the essential part is to know the Supreme Absolute Truth, Krishna, and to surrender to Him. Then one can be casted as Mahatma. Mahatmas are not manufactured in factories. Devotees are also not going to be manufactured in the factories. But one has to show the inclination to surrender to the Supreme Personality of Godhead on His turf, not on our turf. We have to play well. We are given opportunity by the mercy of Srila Prabhupada to develop unalloyed devotional service, that is avyabhicharini bhakti. So we can at least have a glimpse or a little taste of Brahma Bhuyaya Kalpa. In Kali Yuga, to become Brahma Bhuya means self-realized or liberated by other means is extremely difficult, and it's a disqualification. If one tries by Hatha yoga or the, or Gyan, this Gyan, that Gyan, no. It's a disqualification. It's a waste of time. Even so many factions in religion, they want to realize that, yeah, we need a unity, so let's have an interfaith conference. Prabhupada said it's a waste of time. Prabhupada prevented devotees to participate. He said he got so many invitations by Yogi Bhajan and so many times in America. Prabhupada said it's a waste of time. It doesn't mean we discard them. If they come in front, request, we behave perfect. Welcome, have prasadam. That's devotional. It's everything in relation to Krishna to protect your most cherished, most valuable asset is Krishna consciousness. You can't say, let's go. We'll try to preach them and convert them. Oh no, it's a waste of time. Because they don't have faith on Krishna. Even though they have, they are religious, that doesn't mean they are qualified. They do not listen. Prabhupada gave up lectureship in Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan in early time when he was in Mumbai. He would come to Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan. He was invited to become a lecturer in Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan to teach Bhagavad Gita. And he wouldn't compromise. He saw that this is my avadhi. He said, nothing doing. Resigned. This is avyabhichari bhakti. Prabhupada even differentiated, not as discriminating, no, but differentiation about the purpose. He was given order by Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur to write, and he said, if you have money, print it. For printing purpose, he would ask his god brothers, and he was told, first our literature will be, published. Then we will see. Meanwhile, you just simply work here. Prabhupada said, Guru's order cannot be waited, cannot wait. I have to execute. If my god brothers are not going to help me, I will have to seek help outside. Sumati Murarji helped him to publish the 3 volumes of Bhagavatam. R.R. Sheth and Company, they printed this year, 50 years back, 3 trunks of books were loaded on the port of Kochi, accompanying Srila Prabhupada. So they are going to celebrate it. But it shows that a devotee has one-pointed devotional service. One-pointed. Guru's order and satisfaction of Krishna. Yasya prasadat bhagavat prasado yasya. And this happens only on avyabhicharini bhakti. If a devotee, yasya deve para bhakti, yatha deve tatha guru, tasya iti kathita hi arthya prakashante mahatma. A devotee will become self-effulgent or self-outstanding. All the purpose of the Vedas will be revealed to him only if he is having unflinching faith in Guru and Krishna's orders. Now, orders are there, they are unflinching, but executioners should be unflinching. Prabhupada wanted each and every opportunity in favor of executing that order. If his god brothers cannot help, he can't depend upon them. He kept good relationship, but he sought out other avenues and he was successful. Even though he has to go through so many hardships, so many times he has gone to Sumati Murarji's office. But she saw in him a determined person. Single-pointed. She was sympathizer, but at the same time, her sympathy was sentimental. "Oh, Swamiji, you are too old. It is too cold there. I don't want to send you to die there." But he will say, "No, simply, it is my guru's order." So nothing comes in the way. That determination, as a Vaishnava, fellow Vaishnava, she saw in him. And at that time, Jet Airlines already started. They started in 1956, and after 10 years, Srila Prabhupada was moving. Air India is a government, airline. It was flying jets at that time. In 1965, and that to a cargo ship. In 1967, after postgraduate, I went in a ship to the east coast of Africa, because my parents were there and I had happened to be there too before. I just came for education and I went. And I had a cabin, I paid. At that time, only 800 rupees was the ticket. But it would take about 10 days to go. In any source, Prabhupada had nothing but cargo ship. And how many hardships he has. Anyway, Krishna was there. His guru's order was there. He never felt separation. So all these activities are on a spontaneous level, and if avyabhicharini bhakti is there, then and then spontaneity will come. Not otherwise. Otherwise it is a show, immature, risky business to become spontaneous, artificially attached to particular conditions. A pure devotee is not condition bound. His devotional service is unconditioned. Because he is not conditioned, he is liberated. Why should he accept a condition, devotional service? Such devotees are, they can never become employees. They will be the master in command. He can become the commander to make devotees all over the world. So this is extremely important, that in one stroke one can become a pure devotee if he is given opportunity to follow avyabhicharini bhakti. Abhichar is over unprescribed activities. But vyabhichar, this is opposite. That one which is not prescribed and never recommended to be undertaken. But avyabhichari means it is not recommended or restricted or affected by the modes of material nature. It is coming from the turf or desire of Lord Krishna. Whatever he says, we are ready to take up his command. And these commands are internal communication between the pure devotee and Paramatma in his heart. But it comes out from is guru externally. Even though so simple message, but it is perfect and complete. So naturally, this effect of avyabhichari bhakti can easily transcend the three modes or the effects of the three modes of material nature. And put the devotee on that platform, and it cannot be compared with
other so-called devotees. They are struggling.
We are struggling. But Prabhupada gave direct access to this avyabhichari bhakti without any compromise with anybody. All over the world, same thing. That's why within no time it took roots to grow. That is the transcendental process. And one cannot interject any philanthropy in it or sub-religious principles in it. And that is the glory of ISKCON if they stick to it. There are other factions of ISKCON, but they are unwanted philanthropic activities. We can't compromise with that. Prabhupada said, you do not need anything, just preach as I preach. Preach as I preach. You do not have to invent anything. He is giving everything of that category, avyabhicharini bhakti. Never to compromise. Why to compromise? So it's available. But everybody will not take it because they have to grow. So, is there any question or comment?
Hare Krishna Maharaji.
Yeah.
This was tossed with the words, one who engages in full devotional service. What do you mean by full devotional service?
Avyabhichari bhakti is full devotional service, means the devotional service according to Rupa Goswami is Vaidhi bhakti, but the culmination of Vaidhi bhakti will be in Raganuga bhakti. Raganuga bhakti is full devotional service. It is not partial. It's spontaneous. And everything you do is devotional service. Here we have to mechanically, you know, perform certain activities of devotional service, and we may not be able to internally satisfied or situated because the levels are different. So for example, in the beginning, many of us have to wash pots to start our devotional service in the temple. Right? And at that time, there are different kinds of thoughts floating because he doesn't know anything. He can do at least this service, right? But that is mechanical. But washing pots for Krishna's pleasure, if he is understanding that it will please, my work will be pleasing to the devotees and their satisfaction, it is at par with pleasing Krishna. Guru and Krishna will be pleased. We have to put all our heart in whatever we do and make it perfect, given time, you know. Yes. If simply somebody is given a task to perform, say, aarti, they perform with the desire of pleasing Krishna and by behaving himself as if he is behaving with Krishna, with everybody. These are the points being described in third canto of Srimad Bhagavatam when Kapil Dev instructs Mother Devahuti about devotional service that yield
perfect results. So full means perfection. We have to master the art of perfection. As for example, nine steps to prema, right? They have been described that each one has to be mastered, perfected. Shraddha can be perfected because it is generating by association. It should be perfected within the association of the devotees. So what will you do? The process is there. Association, then performing the activities in the association, that is sadhana. Then anartha nivritti should be also done in association, not lonely. Right? Then we'll be benefited faster. So these are pushing us towards perfection stage. So everything has to be covered. Then you verify your faith. That is, it is devoid of all anarthas, nishtha, unshakable faith. Is it not pushing you towards perfection and fullness of the results of the devotional service? So, prem is the perfection. Prema pumartha mahat. In devotional service, it's not only service, it's love. Loving devotional service is called bhakti. Bhakti is not merely service. Those who are not bhaktas, they believe in service, but they don't believe service to Krishna, they are believing service to mankind. And then they quit. Jana seva or Prabhu seva, Manav seva, Madhav seva. That is not devotional service. They don't know. So, bhakti avyabhichari. Yes.
So you said that I think that Thakur said that only by our faith, by Shraddha, we can reach you, go back to God.
By chanting Hare Krishna alone.
By Shraddha, by just by faith.
Just chant Hare Krishna.
Just by faith.
The holy name alone, or the faith on the holy name alone, is showing, giving you the perfection. Because
of my life, I couldn't perfect the chanting of Hare Krishna Mahamantra, but I have faith on holy names.
But it will fructify, it will take time. Now, Haridas Thakur had only faith on the holy name alone. And he perfected. He is the example himself. He doesn't have anything. But that faith alone has also given him opportunity to explain the nama paradas, seva paradas. Even he has not gone to the temple and he has been describing seva paradas. Because the holy name gave him the form of the Lord. So by worshipping the holy name or by serving the holy name, he was serving the Lord. That is the perfection. Then transcendental qualities were emerging. And through those transcendental qualities, he was at par
and qualified to enter into Krishna Leela. That is the perfection. Simply have a faith alone on the holy name. It doesn't mean you have a faith, but how mature your faith is. Therefore, ordinary faith and Shraddha, they have gulf of difference. And Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami gave the definition of Shraddha. It's not a mental aspiration. No, it is intellectually confirmed and fixed up.
This is not Nishtha yet. It is not Nishtha yet, this Shraddha.
We will take time to get Nishtha.
But what about us?
Yes, we will get time because our faith is wavering by slightest inconvenience. The three modes of material nature disturb us. It might be our own shortcoming or some other person or even natural calamities. Yes, if we desire. And if we perfect, we are given full opportunity. It's not that opportunity to advancement is not here in ISKCON. But we should not have ulterior motivations. Anya bilashita shunyam. It doesn't require any expertise.
One lifetime, Prabhupada said, in one moment.
Yes. Why one lifetime? It doesn't take time to become Krishna conscious. But it takes time to retain it, to hold it. Because we have so many things. So it slips away, even though it is available. We can't play around. Can you speak in the mic?
Maharaj, to achieve this goal, we have to do our bhakti without anarthas.
Mm-hmm.
Only then.
Yeah. Anartha means you should be free from all the asaktis.
Asaktis. Attachments.
Not ashakti, asakti.
Asakti attachment.
Right. Hello, Pranam Maharaj. This, it is very difficult to live asakti.
What can you do?
That is
if you come to Vrindavan and bring asaktis, then it will be very difficult to keep up here.
Yeah. But you are future.
The future is bleak. It's not bright. We'll have to take many, many baths. We have to give up the worldly attachment, and attachments are more powerful internally, less powerful externally. So even the tyagis, the false renouncer, they can easily give up, but they cannot give up the internal asakti. Krishna explains that in the third or fourth chapter. One becomes a pakhandi if he says something and does something else. If he has attachment, then he will say bluffing. Prabhupada gives an example of that Mayavadi. If you give him money, he says, no, I don't need. I'm a detached person. I can't touch Maya, but give it to my secretary. That is not anasakta. It's a tyagi, but false tyagi. Pretender. Because his secretary is managing for him everything. So, rather, utilize everything in service of Krishna. Whatever you do, offer to him. This is easy way to become detached, by offering. But then don't take back everything, thinking Krishna is leaving everything behind, so I have to take it. And he is giving me for my entanglement. Don't blame him. He is not giving you for your entanglement. Anasaktasya vishayan yatharam upayunjata. Nirbandhe Krishna sambandhe yukta vairagya muchyate. Prapanchiki taya buddhya hari vastuna sambandhina mumukshu parityago vairagyam phalgu katyate. Phalgu vairagya, yukta vairagya. It is better to be yukta vairagi. Have everything, but utilize in Krishna service. You will have more satisfaction rather than to give up everything. Utilize. Krishna needs, Krishna's devotees needs. ISKCON needs. We want to utilize everything.
No need to take sannyas.
There is no need, but for preaching, Prabhupada said. But Prabhupada and Bhakti Siddhanta, they are better and clever. There is no need to take sannyas for the self satisfaction that but to go out and preach, they are required. Yes. Not Are Baba, bring everything.
Listen.
That's okay. Whatever it is, but that is a service, and this service is not for attachment, but it is for detachment. Does a football has his attachment? He is kicked everywhere. A football, does he have his own attachment? He's being kicked. Okay, go there, go there, go there, go. Yeah. In material football, they are bribing now. Match fixing is found in FIFA. But now, we know where we are going. We have to. We can't be blind.
We're preaching to people.
the samadhi upstairs. They're not sannyasis, but they're preaching. Their spirit is like that. We have men in the Namahata department. Some of them are brahmacharis, some of them are grihasthas. And they're preaching like anything. Their scores are double and triple of
very
what
good.
Downstairs shops are.
Even children are preaching. Even children are preaching.
Children are preaching. Anybody who's a foreigner, stand in one place. I guarantee you at least 10 or 20 people will surround you and wait for you to open your mouth and preach to them.
Mm-hmm. That's correct.
That's the way it is. The opportunities are unlimited. The dress does not matter. Now it's Kali Yuga. And that time Lord Chaitanya had to create a different system.
No, it's not a system. A system is existing. It was recommended in the first three yugas. In Kali Yuga, it is said to be ineffective for self. So for example, up to Dwapara Yuga, sannyasis were going through stage-wise development. He takes sannyas but does not give up the town. He goes out from his home but stays at the edge of the town. There is still attachment of the family members, so they come and supply him food. But that's about it, no other interactions. So he's taught, it's called kutichak. Then he stops that, taking food from there, and goes around the town and get bhiksha and maintains himself without anybody's help. So that is called bahudak stage. But then the third one, he has to give up the town, and he's called parivrajakacharya. He has to travel and preach. Travel and preach. A brahmachari, grahastha, for them it is difficult to travel. Brahmachari is under training, and training cannot be a moving training. There's an establishment, Guru's ashram is there, so he has to stay, and he has to leave for the welfare of Guru, not his welfare. So naturally the ashram and its glories are there. But in Kali Yuga, sannyas, which was mandatory in the previous ages for the fourth purusharth called moksha, that's why they were taking sannyas. But in Kali Yuga, it is forbidden for moksha because we have to go beyond moksha in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So we take the advantage of the system for the purpose of totally depending on Krishna and preaching. Depending on Krishna means the preaching is the only essence. So preachers are required to go all over because that is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's order. Prithvite acha. So it was reintroduced by Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur Maharaj, because after Chaitanya Mahaprabhu nobody took. They took renunciation in the form of Babaji, but staying at one place. They were pure devotees. Bhajanandis were there. Only few were. But and then dynamism to fulfill the mission of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, sannyas has been required. So that is the system. Srila Prabhupada continued by the inspiration of his Guru Maharaj. everywhere.
We should not preach them asakti from the first stage, because people will be frightened. Nowadays.
Why there is asakti to preach only in India?
No, maybe after some time, but in the beginning, how we can preach asakti? We should make them.
Prabhupada's program is perfect. We have to stick to it. We can't invent anything. You know? A devotee who has perfected his life, he should be followed.
He never preached asakti to hippies in the beginning.
And nobody should. Nobody should make them more attached. That is Mayavad. Mayavadi sannyasis or those who want to make a show or business, they may teach them asaktis. But we are not teaching them asaktis. Rather, we have to pull them out. There is no compromise. Is it satisfactory? Good. Thank you very much. Srila Prabhupada ki jai.